Hi friends, today we will do legal dictation exercise number 28. So ready? Start. Per contra learned AGA submitted that if the law enjoins filing of written objection prior to consideration of bail of a convict accused, then it also enjoins grant of time while considering interim bail. Learned AGA further submitted that if a thing is required to be done in a particular manner, then either it should be done in that manner or not at all. He further submitted that amendment was brought by the legislature so that convicts of death sentence, life imprisonment, or for a term of 10 years or more may not be released on bail easily without hearing public prosecutor. Learned AGA therefore submitted that no interim bail should be granted to the appellant without giving opportunity to the state counsel to file objection. On merit, learned AGA argued that conviction of the appellant is sustainable and trial court rightly held them guilty. He supported impugned judgment of conviction and sentence by contending that diary of the deceased indicate that she was maltreated with disrespect. He further submitted on the strength that mother did not support prosecution version as she was compelled for it to save Kedan Prasad from conviction, who was her relative. He further pointed out that PW 4, 5 and 6 have supported prosecution story and therefore evidence of PW 3 was does not damage prosecution case, and for this he pointed out page 90. Ultimately, it was argued that bail of the appellant be refused. Now, analyzing ambit and scope of the proviso attached to section 389 of the code, it transpire that the said proviso relates to only to a procedure and does not affect or curtail power of the appellate court in the matter of grant of bail. It nowhere restricts or creates an embargo on such a power. What it provides is not only a procedure to be observed while considering bail of a convict accused, sentenced with death, life imprisonment or imprisonment for 10 years or more. Thus, the legislative intent was never to curtail power of appellate court in matters of grant of bail, but only to hear public prosecutor. Scope of such a proviso, therefore, cannot be stretched to scuttle power to the court to grant interim bail. It was rightly argued that a proviso may carve out an exception but cannot curtail limits of parent section. For the sentence of less than 10 years of imprisonment is beyond the purview of said proviso, where its observance of granting time to the public prosecutor to file written objection can be skewed, albeit hearing of public prosecutor may be strictly adhered to. Thus, the proviso has been added as an abundant caution only. Otherwise, normally, but for certain aberration, no bail in appeal against conviction is considered without hearing public prosecutor. Mandatory character of granting time to file written objection and hearing public prosecutor has been enacted only to skew aberration and block loophole of hearing state counsel in matter of grant of bail after conviction. Thank you. Please subscribe my channel Steno Star.